food, no. But Peter, when he went and sat down with those Gentiles, they fed him all kinds of stuff. Dirty, stinky feet after they came off of that long walk. Sit down, stinking. Peter enjoying that barbecue.
Uh-oh.
Ham. Pig's feet. He just had a good time.
Tearing the ribs up.
How is this okay, Peter? They have faith in Jesus Christ. That's all we're trying to get them to is faith in Jesus Christ. If you go to a Gentile, I mean a real showing up Gentile. I heard somebody, I was at Brother Wayne's house the other day. How many were over there at his birthday party? This little dear sister invited me to Louisiana so she could feed me
gumbo.
Yeah, gumbo, but with armadillo.
Ooh, yes,
he's
got the armadillo. Yes,
there's some armadillo in there. I'm saying, "Whoa, Brother Wayne, come help me. Your sister's going to feed me armadillo and all this kind of stuff in the gumbo." He said, "Yeah, that's how they do it down there." I said, "Oh, no, boy." Oh, that's all right.
Don't tell me, then.
They do it like that.
They do it, yeah.
Did you eat it?
No. I mean, that's how they do it.
Well, they didn't have armadillo there. They just told me to come to Louisiana and have some.
We're
going to
reach some real gumbo, armadillo and all this. I said, whoa, you're going to put what in it? Yes, Peter, when God brought that vision to him, it was all kind of what creepy things and stuff were going on. These people are eating. That's what their life is all around, you know. They'll say, you live in a neighborhood where there's weed crack and all this and all that going on around you. How is it that this person is right with God with all that around them? Because it's from the inside. They don't know nothing about the word. It's from the inside. They live for God. There's something about being right with God on the inside. They don't know nothing about the law, how you're supposed to go to church and act in church. No, they don't do nothing like that. But that's the world that God is sending us into.
Yeah.
But if you go into that world with the do's and the don'ts and dot the I's, cross the T's, they're going to look at you and say, what?
I was doing family.
What? Get that little girl out of those pants and put her on a what? Skirt. What? Get that little kid, that little girl out of that swimming pool. She can't go swimming with those boys. She's been doing it, what, all her life?
Yeah. Yeah.
She can't play sports, run track. You know? She's been, what, doing it all her life? She don't know nothing about, what are you talking about? So, this is what Jesus is saying. If you live that way according to the law, you won't get close to heaven, and nobody else that you talk will get close to heaven.
Mm.
Oh, man. So, that's what we got there. Now we're going to say Romans 9 and 30. We read that. Okay, we're going to get back to our lesson. You have heard that it was said by them of what kind of time?
Old time.
What time could that have been? Oh, way back. Not coming forward. It's way back. Mm-hmm. From the time that the prophets and the law showed up. That's how far he's reaching back. You have heard it was said by them of old. Thou shalt not do what?
Kill.
Uh-oh. Whoever shall kill shall be what?
Dangerous.
Okay, now, watch out, class. Is capital punishment lawful? Let's see. What case? Popular case. Can't even think of one that has been lately.
Chicago.
How's that?
In Chicago, when they killed the
black boy.
Mm-hmm. Really? Yeah. How about the black guy that was drugged by the truck in Texas? they drug him for so many miles, and I forgot what town it was in.
Jasper, Texas.
Yeah, drug. Okay, we got him. They're guilty as can be. Should we kill these guys?
Yeah.
Should we put these guys to death for what they did to this innocent man?
Actually, the law said yes.
Put the question to the court. Thou shalt not kill. That's what the word says, right?
Yeah.
And whoever kills should be put to the danger of judgment.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, they feel him.
So you have been said. It's been said of old. Said of old, thou shalt not kill. Now it's not talking about capital punishment.
It's not. The law, it was
Let's
capital
see what
punishment.
It's talking about. What is he talking about? What's he talking about? I don't know. It's in Genesis 9 and 6. Probably the first capital case. What does it say?
Whoso sheddeth man's blood, by man shall his blood be shed, for in the image of God made he man.
Is that the law? Or is that New Testament stuff? So that's the law. That's what they said back in the old days. Whosoever should shed a man's blood, by him shall his blood be what? Shed. You kill somebody, you're going to take your life.
Okay, hold on, Brother Donnell.
Okay.
This is God's law.
It's God's law.
Right.
That's right.
A man.
All right.
Got a law too.
All right.
So they can't go up to God and say, hey, this is our law.
Okay, you're right. You're right. Whatever law man got, it's got to be in union with God's law.
Right, that's what I was just going to say. So they can't have an excuse to say, hey, this was our law on earth. But at the same time, you should have my law.
Okay.
So it's no excuse, right?
No, we're going to get to him. I'm going to get to
him. I got to get me to the ground.
Okay, here we go. Show a man as capital punishment in God's order is war. War. Send a man to war. Sister Sylvia's son went to the military, right?
Mm-hmm. I went to the military, but
Bunny went to the military. If we had to, I faced my enemy and he had a weapon toward me, should I say what God said don't shoot?
That's different.
That's killing.
That's different.
Okay, it's different because we're talking capital punishment. I'm talking war.
Okay. Then Moses and David, they all went to war.
Went to war.
Okay, did they kill?
They killed.
All right.
Okay. Killing.
Right.
It's killing
than it's war.
It's a different killing than war. War is killing, and the man's killing. Take a man's blood, take a man's life out of him. We'll take your life, whether it's on the football field or the war field. I'm taking your life. Can I take his life if he's going to take mine? Because the law says, thou shalt not, Jesus says, you heard how it said, thou shalt not kill. And then you saw it said, over there, you shouldn't take a man's blood. If you do, your blood will be required. So, on the earth, I'm facing a man, it's coming my life or his life.
But the word also says you face the judgment.
Face the judgment.
So, I mean, if you kill a man, he's got to take your life, and you kill him, mm-hmm. then you're going to be judged by man, mm-hmm. which would judge you as self-defense.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And that way, you get off by self-defense. Mm-hmm. Because man's law says mm-hmm. that if you're protecting yourself, you mm-hmm. get that.
Mm-hmm. But that's man law.
That's man's
law. That's
man law. So I should let him kill me?
No.
Oh, self-defense.
Okay. We have to kill him.
Right, exactly.
Kill him.
Yeah.
So, Jesus is saying that if you do stuff by the letter and the tilt, the tap of the law, you see how you get boxed in? I'm hungry, starving to death, can't even go over to give me no food because it's Sunday, not Sabbath day. So I can't even heal that person because it's the Sabbath day. The law. Living by the letter. I can't heal them. Gotta wait, hope you live till.
Now you know the Jehovah's Witness, they'll go to the pen before they go to the army. Now
Think about it, because we have such a good nation that says if you got a conscience, if you got a mental thing about killing, we don't want you in the army anyway. You got to be able to say, yeah, I'll kill him.
Muslims the same way.
Muslims same way. They don't want them either.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, they don't. Used to they send you to jail if you didn't go.
Yeah, but they kind of need the conscientious objection. Like I said, I call it a conscientious objector to war. Mm-hmm. It's best that he's not around though, because he was off.
I don't want him in my army.
He won't kill that one guy that's trying to blow us up. Yeah. We ain't gonna want him around.
Well, he ain't got your back.
Yeah, we don't want him around. Mm-hmm. So this is why Jesus is trying to point out to them that if you just live it in that little box, not a little box, but that little confines of what the law says, he says you're not going to make it into heaven. And he's using some strong examples here. Thou shalt not kill. What are you going to do? Yeah, well, he says, so now, here's how New Testament people can say that I can fulfill the law, what was said from old days. I can fulfill it. That's what Jesus says. I can live it. I can live it out. This is the only way you can do it. 1 John 3:15. That's fine. Let's go there. We can go there before we go to our verse. 1 John 3:15. Someone tell me what time it is.
20 after.
Okay, gotta move fast. So Jesus is gonna tell you what a real murderer is. If anybody does, go ahead and read it.
Whosoever hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him.
So Jesus is saying, equates 1 John 3:15 to Genesis 9:6. That's what he called murder. He's on the same level. So if you hate your brother,
hold on back up. Okay. So a murder. So what he's saying that is a killing, or it's just a murder.
A murder. I mean, you took his life from him.
Okay.
Took his life from him. Took his life. And he says if you go around hating your brother, he says that's on the same level as shooting him through the heart, and killing him. Ooh. Wow. So, if you go around and talking about your brother, talk about behind his back, well, you used to command both of you, but then talk about it. You just killed him. Just killed him. If you argue, or if you do something that you think you got liberty to do in front of your brother, and it caused your brother to backslide.
Yeah. No, I'm murderer.
You are a murderer. Woo! And it caused that brother to backslide. You are a murderer. So let's finish. Let's read that out. What does it say? 1 John 3:15. Did we read it?
Yes.
We read it.
Yeah.
Okay, now let's go back to our lesson. I say unto you that whosoever is angry with his brother without a cause should be in danger of the judgment. Whosoever should say to his brother, Raka, should be in danger of the council. And that was the law then. That if you are got something against your brother and you know you shouldn't be like that against your brother, then the council, the Sanhedrin, the Pharisees would bring you up and they'll put you in judgment. Should be in danger. That's what the council is. That's man's council. But whosoever should say, thou fool, should be in danger of what? Hellfire. That's why he says, if you curse your brother, you're in danger of hellfire. He says, I got a tougher one than that. You go around here, get mad at Rod Travis because he ain't the whatever. And you just blast him out. Rod, you thought of you show us real trouble? Yeah, you might as well put a bullet through your head. What's going to happen? There you go.
You got me for Bill
Cosby. There you go. Shall I you jump on Sister Sylvia and blast her out and do all that? You ain't going.
What if you ask for forgiveness?
Oh, you better hurry up. Because Shirley can't even go to prayer. Shirley says, I'm just going to go to prayer and pray about it. What are you praying about? God says what? Before you get down here on your knees, do what? Go back over there. And get that straight. Put people to do what? Glass and brothers and sisters, and then comes over to prayer meeting. God said, you just committed murder. How you coming in here tomorrow to pray?
That's what we talked about Monday.
How you coming in here to pray? Yeah. It ain't happening.
Ooh. That remember what Bill Cosby said before.
Yeah.
He was talking about a book he wrote that, and they wanted to know how he got the title for it. He was talking about his daughter was mad at the mother and all, and about the room, and that the daughter, you know, said, "Well, I wish I hadn't been born." And he said, I thought of three things to say. He said, but I didn't say none of them, because none of them would get me on the list to get into heaven.
So here's what it's, remember someone in the Bible says, be angry and sin not? Okay, and this is, see, this is where the sin continues in verse 23 and 24. Therefore, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, come into the altar to pray, in thy remembrance that thy brother has aught against thee. You and somebody else got a conflict going on. He says, leave thy gift there at the altar and go thy way. First be what? Reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer up this sacrifice of praise that you're going to come in here offer up. Ooh. Man. Agree with thine enemy, how? Quickly. While thou art in the way with him, at least at any time the adversary deliver thee to the who? Judge. And the judge deliver thee to who? The officer. And thou be what? Cast in the prison. That's civil stuff. Fighting over the fence line. Something like that. You know? Don't let that stuff go to the, well, we're just going to go to court. I'm going to sue you and I'll see you in court.
That reminds me of what we used to say to the kids when they'd be fussing, you better get it straight before I have
to. Yeah, you want me to settle it?
You want me to settle it?
Then they look at each other and say, come on, man, that's straight back up. You don't hear me. You don't want to be dealing with you. You don't know which way you're going to go. You know? That's straight. So let's straighten it out. So, verily I say unto thee, thou shalt by no means come out thence till thou hast paid the uttermost what? Father. I mean, if you take it to court,
taking you to court,
you
dirty dog.
Now he's saying your brother. He ain't saying about those people out in the world that ain't gonna do you right no matter how saved you are. Some people ask you, they don't care how saved you, they're gonna take advantage of you. But you got your brother, Curtis, you and McClellan can't get along, y'all gonna fight it out, you gonna take McClellan to court. And then one of y'all gonna wind up on the bad side. And then it'll be coming. One of y'all will be coming to Monday night prayer. God's gonna say.
So the word says you're not gonna take your brother to court.
You don't have to take your brother to court.
The word says
the law will box you into that. The law will box you into that. But grace and truth will say, hey, brother, we love each other. There's gotta be a way for us to straighten this out.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? There's gotta be a way. I hurt you, I'm sorry. You hurt me, okay. But we can't be going and thinking we're going to go to prayer with this stuff going on between. Come on, we got to get this.
Brother Rob be up all the ribs.
Yeah, Brother Rob be up all the ribs. Leave the bones. Don't clean up.
We just make him bring the ribs next
time. Yeah, Rob, we got the solution. Yeah. This time we're going to do two orders of ribs.
That was two examples. I ate all two.
I think that made sense, Brother Rob. I think I would be.
To bring the ribs to the
house. Boy, they tried to get away.
They tried to get away.